video. This is our very first video, and today we're going to be going to Ruby Mountain. It's in Chaffee County, Colorado, about 15 minutes south of Buena Vista, and we're going to be finding garnets and Apache tears, which are obsidian pebbles, and hopefully find some topaz that's located there.
You cross over the Arkansas, which is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, this thing is, that's beautiful. It's 35 mile an hour, but I think she's going about 15. Let's see what she's doing. It won't show us, but she's going slow.
25.
We actually met some people at camp, and they're behind us, and we're going to show them today where to find the garnets and the obsidian. The Apache tears are some of the coolest things ever, and there's a really cool story behind it, and Johnny Cash has a song. So yeah, you cross the railroad. I haven't seen a train yet, and the weeds are grown up, so I don't even think trains come down it anymore. But this was all a bunch of mining country back here. There was thousands of people. Leadville, which is about 30 miles north of here, was actually supposed to be the capital of Colorado. They had about 200,000 people back in the early 1900s. There's something out there. There's an antelope.
Ooh, he's way out there.
It's a male. He's got some horns on him. He's all by himself. He's a loner. Look at him. There he stands up. All right, I changed to my zoom lens so we can get a better video of them.
So a little history about Ruby Mountain. It's been prospected since the 1880s, and early prospectors actually mistook what they were finding for rubies, so they were super pumped. Later found out the rubies are actually just garnets, so disappointing for them, but garnets are beautiful.
Yeah, they're awesome. And you can see all over this area, people have mined. There's an old creek bed, people have mined down in there. I mean, this is all placer. There's a bunch of glaciers that ran through here and deposited a bunch of gold and minerals. And those are all the Collegiate Peaks over there. And I believe right over there, that might be Mount Ontario. I believe so, don't you?
Yeah, I think so.
I think that's Mount Ontario, so.
And to the right is Mount Princeton.
And Mount Princeton right there. So we're wanting to go up there, camp at Treeline. I don't know if you can see that. Way up there, camp at the Treeline, and then stay there a couple days and hike and look for some aquamarines. But we got to find the plat map so we're not on claims. People get shot doing that stuff. So there's Ruby Mountain right in front of us, the first glimpse of it.
Woo!
If I can get a better video.
Oh,
there's
look,
sun
people are
glare.
Rafting.
Oh yeah, check it out. So there's the Arkansas River, there's Ruby Mountain. We're getting close, y'all. So you just hike up that hill. It's really not that bad. It's about a 15-minute walk at most. And we're not from here, so it's a lot harder for us. All right, guys, we made it. There's Ruby Mountain. There's a little information up here we'll show you. Here's the wildlife you can see and all about the goats, actually the sheep. And then here's more information about it. This actually shows us where we're at. Let's see. So we're right here, and there's Ruby Mountain just straight up ahead of us. And here's the trail. Alright guys, so you keep going down this trail and you can see this white wall up here. If you're really feeling adventurous, you can actually climb it, and that's where a lot of the Apache tears are. So we'll show you how we did it. It's not real steep, but you gotta take your time.
Ooh, there she is. We made it to Ruby Mountain! Hey guys!
We made it. So we're about to climb up this mountain, and we'll show you the obsidian. It's all in this white wall right here, so just bear with us.
This. He's a
All right, guys, we finally made it up there. We're wore out. And as you can see, she's up here just picking up obsidian.
Right here? They're all over the ground.
They're just little black obsidian pebbles. They call them Apache tears. And I mean, they're just all over this perlite here. And you can see we're way up here now.
So these are obsidian nodules. Like you said, they're called Apache tears because there was a tribe here called the Apache tribe, and they fought the U.S. and they were severely outnumbered. So instead of getting killed by the Americans, they actually rode their horses off the cliff. And the legend has it that the Apache women heard about this and cried, and their tears turned to stone. Johnny Cash actually has a song explaining it. It's a beautiful song.
Yeah, it's a really great song. Any song by Johnny Cash is amazing.
Hoof prints and footprints, deep ruts the wagons made. The victor and the loser came by here. No headstones, but these bones rend Mescalero death moans. See the smooth black nuggets by the thousands lying here. Petrified but justified are these Apache tears. Dead grass, dry roots.
So we're going to go back down and show you the actual trail that goes up to the top, because going up that right there can be a little dangerous. And as you can see, if you don't wear gloves, bust your hands all up.
Apache tears. The young men, the old men.
All right, so right over there is where we parked. And you just come up this trail, and it leads you all the way up the mountain.
The white man.
So, we'll show y'all.
No fight ever took this land, so don't raise the dust when you pass here. They're sleeping, and in my keeping are these Apache tears.
And that outcropping right there behind Kendall is where we find a lot of the garnets in those big rocks. So you just go up and then go left and follow that ridge top, and there's garnets all in those rocks right there. All right, guys, so when you're walking up this side of the mountain here, watch out for these cactuses, because we've already been stuck a few times, and if you have kids or dogs or whatever, you know, you just want to make sure that they're not getting these in their paws or their feet. And they're everywhere, literally everywhere. I'll show you here. And they pack a punch. You can see they're all over this, all up through there, if you can see that. You know, just covering the ground. You don't want one of those in your feet. As you work your way up, you'll see them, and just be cautious. The west slope, see this private property right here? That's all this slope right here, which is apparently where you can find topaz, but it's all off limits, all this west slope. Guys, so when you get on top of the ridge, you want to go left, and the best garnets we've found so far have been down this point. And I don't guess people want to walk this far, because it's usually not worked as much, and we can find a ton of garnets up here. And all these little rocks, if you don't have a rock hammer or something to bust, you can look through those and just pick them up. They'll usually have a garnet in them,
like this one.
Oh yeah, just like that. That's awesome. All right, guys, so we just found this outcropping and this little rock that someone's already been chiseling on, and it's just covered in garnets. Kendall's gonna point them out here. There's several of them.
Here's a good one. Ooh, look right here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's just tons of them. There's a really good one. It's not flickering in the sun yet, but when we pull it out, we'll teach y'all how to do that. And then there's another one over here.
Oh, that's a good one.
It's just sitting right in that little bug right there on that rock. So that'll be a good one to get out. So what Kendall's gonna do,
I've got my handy dandy tool, tweezers. And what you do, okay, so what you do is you put the tweezers around the ruby and just, garnet, and just give it a little wiggle and it'll pop right out. Are you ready? Okay, so I squeeze it and it popped right off.
All right, here you go.
All right, once again, we're just gonna put the tweezers around it carefully and give it a little wiggle. There it goes.
So there they are, guys. There's two garnets. It's just easy as that. You just, like she said, put those tweezers around it, give it a little wiggle. Some of them are a little harder, and you can break them too. But anyway, that's basically how you do it. We'll show you again.
Here's one.
All right.
That's a good size. All right.
You found one down here in this little crevice. Some of them are a little hard. We'll see.
There it goes.
All right.
It has a lot of host rock on it, but it's a really good size.
Yeah, you can see it compared to the other ones. Yeah, just look at that. That's so much bigger. And you can see that sparkle. Oh, that's pretty. All right, so another technique. Tweezers are the best because you can just get in there. Like there's one right there, there's one over here, she's gonna pop off, and they're just, you know, covering these rocks. If you really wanna be like me and start banging on something, cause I love to break me some rocks, you can bring your rock hammers. And what I'm gonna do is set the camera up and I'll show you what we're talking about. All right, guys, so still on that same rock we found, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break off a big chunk and expose some new rock and hopefully find some better garnets. Because most of these rocks around here have been picked over and looked at, but I don't think people know the tweezer trick. So if you bring those, you'll get a pocket full quick. All right, guys, so I was banging on this rock, and as you see all these little pieces, hopefully that's in focus, you can see these little garnets popping out. Kendall will get the tweezers too. There's one right in here, there's a couple here, one back in this little bug right here, one up here. So you wanna always check whenever you break off a piece, because a lot of times there'll be little garnets on it. And hopefully you'll get lucky and find a big one, which we haven't found one yet today, but we found a few. Here's a nice one though. You can see it's a little covered in that host rock, but Kendall's gonna get those tweezers to them and we're gonna collect those up.
What I've been doing is going around and just picking up rocks like this and checking them, and often there's garnets left behind that people either missed or maybe didn't have tweezers to get them out with. Frank did awesome breaking up this rhyolite. Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah.
All right, guys, so there's a really good size one on here that Frank got, and he busted off the big chunk. I'm gonna put my tweezers around it and give it a little wiggle.
Just a
that
little
one didn't
wiggle.
Take much. Add to the collection.
Nala, come on, girl. Come on.
We're trying to kill the camping neighbor.
Good girl. She's such a little mountain dog. Come on, girl. Come on. How you gonna do it now, girl? You done messed up. Come on. Good girl. It's like surfer day. Yeah. Here's the hole where they were getting that big chunk of perlite with Apache tears all up under here.
Here's a few.
Oh yeah, there's a good chunk. You can see the Apache tears still in the rock.
Host rock.
The host rock. Mm-hmm. The perlite. And people have been digging under these trees. I wouldn't advise that. I would dig down where you can dig without tearing anything up.
Find them along the trail.
Yeah, you can find them along the trail.
Here's a good piece.
Yeah, look at this. Somebody left some big chunks of it. That's cool.
Look at my vines.
Oh yeah, I'd keep those. Boy, look at that chunk.
Woo. Oh, here's a big one.
Good job. Here's another good piece. They're just laying all over the trail. It's a good spot to find them. Especially still in the host rock. Most of the time they're loose. Here you go. These are good pieces. You can have them.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. 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 That's right. All right, guys, we're leaving Ruby Mountain. There's the campsites. We had to go back up because Doug, our camping neighbor, lost his keys. So we got all the way to the bottom and he was looking for his keys and we had to travel all the way back up the mountain. So we're plumb tuckered.
But we found them.
But we found them, that's right. So the day was good. All right, guys, so we just left Ruby Mountain and we got a competition going to see who can see the first animal that we haven't yet. And one of the ones on our list were sheep, and Kendall found them first. Check that out. Boy, he's eyeing me. Got a game going right now. Whoever can spot the first animal that we haven't seen yet wins. I found the moose first and she found the sheep. He just crawls on his knees. That's so cool.
Did you know they did that?
Huh. Some locals that you could go to Ski Cooper and see moose on the moose migration, and we just got lucky and found our first one. I was like, babe, what is that?
Ready? Thanks guys for watching our video. We'd really appreciate it if you'd like and comment on this video, and please subscribe to our channel.
Thank y'all so much again. Just remember, when you come up here, bring your tweezers, lots of water. Make sure you bring plenty of snacks because it's a long hike and a long day when you're up here. And there's so much to explore up here, a lot of gems and minerals to find. And we just really appreciate y'all and we thank you again. Come on.
don't forget to subscribe.